In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the base flange feature in SolidWorks. In this demonstration, I'm going to use 2018, which may have more options than older versions, but the basic concepts are the same across all currently available versions. I'll show you the three different ways to use this feature: the profile sketch method, the tab feature, and the close sketch method. To create a sheet metal part in SolidWorks, you need to start by creating a base flange. A base flange feature provides a foundation from which you can build your part. One of the most common ways of creating a sheet metal body is by creating a base flange using a profile sketch. To do this, we start by clicking the base flange feature in the sheet metal tab. If the sheet metal tab is not active, simply right-click on any of the tabs and click the sheet metal to check and activate it. Next, we'll select a plane by left-clicking. This activates the sketch mode, so we will create a sketch. And I like to use the mouse gestures and hotkeys, so I apologize if it's hard to follow along. We will follow good practice and add some dimensions to fully constrain our sketch. Essentially, what we're doing here is creating a profile of the part geometry, and then we will extrude this profile using the base flange feature. So once the sketch is defined to the desired dimensions, we will click the Exit Sketch button to complete the sketch and enter the base flange feature editor. So this is where we are actually creating the sheet metal body and editing those parameters. The first field labeled Direction 1 is where we can set the extrude length. Notice the different options, which are the same as the standard SolidWorks extrude options. We have blind, up to vertex, up to surface, offset from surface, and midplane. Since we have no other geometry in this part file, our only real options here are blind, meaning one direction from the active plane, and midplane, meaning both directions symmetrically from the active plane. I'll go with blind. I'll set the extrude dimension to 20 inches, and now we can start to see what our body will look like. So there's some other options here that I will not be using. We could add a second direction to our extrude if necessary. Could check the Use Gauge Table box to select our material information from a gauge table. Gauge tables are a whole topic in itself, but basically it just allows you to pick a material which will pull some of these next parameters from a predefined list or Excel spreadsheet. It is a very handy option, but unless you have the gauge tables set up for your specific company and your specific designs and available materials, it's really not that useful. So since we aren't using a gauge table, we can input the sheet metal parameters manually. So I'll choose a 60,000ths of an inch material thickness and use the 1:1 thickness to radius ratio rule of thumb, and use a 60,000ths radius as well. Another important note, always be conscious of the direction the sheet metal is being formed from the profile sketch. So notice the difference when I check and uncheck the reverse direction box here. This is a common place for errors to occur because the direction obviously affects the dimensions of the part. So there you have it. That's how to create a basic sheet metal part using the base flange profile sketch method. Now let's take a look at how to add some geometry to this part by using the tab feature. So let's add a slotted tab onto our part now that we have the general geometry completed. We can add it onto any flange or face of the part by clicking the face and creating a sketch of the geometry we wish to add. So all we have to do is click the face we want to add to and click the base flange button again, and then it takes us into sketch mode to create the geometry. So I'll create that geometry for the slotted tab. And once that is complete and fully defined, I complete the sketch and the tab feature is created and added to our part. So the other way of creating a sheet metal part using the base flange feature is the close sketch method. To do this, we click the base flange button, we select a plane to sketch on, and that'll open the sketch mode. Similarly to creating a tab feature, we just sketch the exact geometry of the flange we want to create. I'm fast forwarding through the sketching portion of the video just because I want to focus on the sheet metal aspects. So I apologize if it's hard to follow those parts of the video. So once we have that geometry created, when we exit the sketch mode, it prompts us to enter the parameters of the base flange feature. So since we have the exact 2D geometry of this part created, all we have to do is enter the sheet metal parameters like thickness, direction, K-factor, etc. So once we check that off as complete, we have a sheet metal body. And we can do all the same things like add tabs to this. So I'll just show that quick. And then like I said, the base flange is the starting point usually when you're designing a sheet metal part from scratch. So from this, we can add things like edge flanges or miter flanges or hems or all those different types of other sheet metal features that SolidWorks has available. But typically, these are the starting points for creating that sheet metal body, and then Once we have this, we can build off of it to create more complex geometries and add to our sheet metal parts. In later videos, I'll be covering all the different other features of sheet metal. So I think the next one will be the edge flange feature. So definitely check that one out if you want to keep building on this and follow along with me as I release these videos. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, comment below. If you liked what you see, please give me a like. And of course, make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so you can get all these videos as I'm releasing them. And one more thing, leave me a comment. Let me know what you think about the SolidWorks videos if you want to see more of this stuff. I know there's some other channels that are covering these things, but I'm always happy to make custom videos for anybody that wants to see specific things. So please be sure to share any video ideas or other feedback you have for me. So with that, thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time.